Lincoln, you were sight for sore. Merle's holed up over at Perlis. What I hear, he's pissed as all hell. Wish I could see that asshole's face right about now.
Just so we're on the same page, once I'm in there, I'm killing any motherfucker who gets in my way.
Ain't no one shedding tears for those pricks. You do what you think's best.
I'll be seeing you, Laveau. Could use some supplies. Heard you were the man to talk to.
Cassandra said you might be calling. I'm happy to help, but I ain't running no charity either.
Sorry.
You want something? You let me know.
Show me what you got.
Still can't believe one of those jigaboo motherfuckers has a boss come after us.
Just the local collar. Show them they're upset.
Stop. Here I come.
Huh?
He's still here.
Damnation!
One more time, how a goddamn nigger just strolled on through here without a care in the world. Do it!
I'm sorry, Merle, but I wasn't even here. I'm just...
That motherfucker took some of our best girls.
Huh?
You get that dope in them, they suck a potato out of pain. Jesus Christ! Ah! Well, what you gonna do, nigger?
This. Dixie motherfuckers are out of Perlis. Have your men come lock it down.
In 1966, the FBI recruited me out of college. Chicago was my first assignment, but I was transferred down south in 68. I stayed there until 86, when I was promoted to assistant director of the criminal enterprise branch. I stayed with the Bureau until my retirement in 1999. Oh, there are so many stories about Cassandra. As a girl, she was kidnapped, killed, and brought back to life by a voodoo priest. She watched swamp rats rape and murder her sister. She shot her own father and dumped his body in the swamps. It's impossible to know what's true.
Okay, just stay out of my way.
Changing anytime soon.
Uncle Billy told me he helped you.